so in terms of dynamics, dynamics are pretty much going to be all dependent on how much air you're blowing into the horn, which you want to kind of draw from your diaphragm. But if you want to play soft, just don't blow in much air, and you want to play loud, blow in a lot of air. It's fairly simple, but the challenge of it is on higher pitches, it can be challenging to play soft at first because you need a lot of muscle support with your lips while also blowing only a small amount of air. But I'll go ahead and give you an example of soft versus loud. Side is used on the higher range, and the F side, the longer side, is used for the lower notes. If I just play the horn open, not holding down any of the valves on the F side, I'll just play a middle C. You hear that pitch, but if I go down a half step, what I need to do for that is hold down the second valve. And what that does is, by holding down the second valve, more of this tubing here is open to the airflow, so the horn is slightly lengthened, which is why the pitch is lowered. And essentially, you go, if you want to go down, open, second, first, first and second, second and third, first and third, and one, two, three. That is the basic series for going down by half steps. However, as an actual horn player, it gets more complicated than that because as you go up, you'll switch most of the notes from the F side to the B flat side, so some of the notes you'll play, you'll need to hold down the trigger as well, but it really just depends on the note. So I'll go ahead and play a quick chromatic scale so you can see how my fingers are changing while I do that. I'll start on the middle C, and I'll just go up one octave to the upper C.